Hi, Carrie and Mosaic. This is Nancy again. And in this video, we're going to talk about the sides of the hooves and take a real good look at where those heels actually are. And I want to remind everybody who doesn't know Mosaic, here she is. She's a paint mare. She was bought by Carrie some months ago, and she's been lame off and on since she got her, including some abscessing, which occurred after Carrie took off her shoes. She had been shod on the fronts, but not on the backs, and that's pretty common. Just to remind you again, these are Mosaic's front feet. This is the left front dorsal, and this is the right front dorsal. And remember that we had seen some flaring on these feet. These here, the flaring on the right front is pretty obvious. And then we also looked at the back of her feet and noticed that there was some curling under where you see the arrow on the lateral side. Let me take a second here to remind everyone that the advice I'm giving is based on a picture and not on the real horse. So everything I say has to be taken with a grain of salt until the trimmer actually goes out and looks at the feet of the live horse and determines that what I saw in the photo is actually there. Because photos can be very deceiving because of camera angle, because of movement, because of lighting, because of just lots of things. So even though I'm giving advice online, it's a risky business because of the nature of photography. So that's just a little bit of a warning before we get on to the side of these feet. This is the lateral side of Mosaic's left front foot. All kinds of things are going on here, and we can see why I said in the previous video that the back of the heels can be very deceiving. Because if I were to draw a line from where I think the heel starts to where the heel ends, you can see that this heel is actually quite high. It's just lying in the wrong direction. If I were to take a hold of it, you can see that this heel is actually that tall, but it's lying horizontally instead of vertically. And that's why the back of a foot might also tend to roll under, because what's actually happening is this heel has been weakened because it's lying horizontal to the tubule's strength and bending them over and forward. On this version of the same hoof, I've tried to duplicate in lines the angle of the tubules as they grow down the hoof. This line here shows you that the tubule that starts probably two-thirds of the way down the side of the coronary band actually ends up almost at the toe. These solid lines are more the angle that tubules should grow. When tubules grow this way, because of their internal structures, which are spirals, the tubule is able to hit the ground and compress and absorb the concussion of the ground. Also, because it's hitting on the end of a tubule, it tends to be strong. Whereas these tubules, which are growing at a more acute angle, are actually bending so that when they hit the ground, they hit their sides instead of their tips. When they hit their sides, as is happening at this heel, the tubules are not able to compress, absorption of concussion does not occur, and the tubules just keep bending. As the condition worsens, the tubules grow longer and longer and more on their sides, forcing the heel to migrate forward or migrate outward. I'm going to use this diagram to help allay all the fears that people have that if they affect what appear to be very low heels, they will actually lower the heels too far. What I want to show you is that that is really not true. What's actually happening is the heel is hitting at this point first, and then it's rocking back and hitting at that point before the horse actually goes to break over and lifts its foot. If you were to draw a line, as we tell you in the hoof print trim method, that goes from the baseline 1 1/8 inches down perpendicular to the ground and draw a line parallel to the ground across the hoof, what you'll see is that line will hit in two places. The first place it will hit is that lowest point where the hoof hits after it's hit in this mid area. And you can see that hitting here is going to be much more beneficial to the horse because that's going to be at the end of a tubule instead of along the sides of the tubule. You'll also notice that this line touches the place where the hoof has naturally trimmed itself. This is where the side of this hoof actually wants to be. What's actually happened here is because this point, the first point the heel touches the ground, is too high, it's pushing the back portion of the lateral cartilage up. You can see how much this high point on the heel has forced the back of the heel upward if you look at this line. This is a line I've drawn at a 30 degree angle to the ground. It's touching the top of the coronary band here, and it's touching the ground way back here. But you can see where this hairline should be here, it's actually been forced up right here. By taking this area away, you can allow the lateral cartilage to relax again and come down into a more natural position. Using the same logic on the left front foot as we used on the right front foot, we should be able to determine what's wrong with this foot. And you can see that the hairline looks to be a little more obtuse than the 30 degrees. The heel is underrun going from here all the way to here. Again, it's in the middle of the foot. I believe the toe is a little long. And this foot also, because of the fact that the heel has migrated so far, there's an awful lot of bruising on this side of the foot. I'm going to show you a little bit of computer magic using a program called Preview on my Macintosh, but there are any number of programs like this. They're drawing programs. And what I'm going to do is show you how to determine a line that approximate a 30 degree angle. It's based on geometry. First, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a square. And generally in these drawing programs, it's called rectangle. And if you draw it, you can make your rectangles be any shape you want. But I want a square. And the way to do that is hold down your shift key. And that will give you a perfect square. Then inside that square, I'm going to draw an oval. But I don't want an oval. I want a perfect circle. So again, I'm going to hold down my shift, and I'm going to draw a perfect circle. And then I'm going to get a hold of that circle and put it inside the square. Again, I hold down the shift key. And what I've done, I've created a circle that is tangent to the square. And what that does is it divides the sides of the square exactly in half. Since we know that one third of a 90 degree angle is 30 degrees, all we have to do is go and draw a line from the corner of the square to where the circle hits the square. And then extend that line, always making sure that the line continues to touch the important parts of the square. Then all you have to do is select your square and your circle, and you have a 30 degree line. And all you have to do is select it and put it on your foot. And you can see that this 30 degree line shows that this heel is being pushed up again by the fact that the hoof is landing first here, then rocking back here. If we cut off this entire area here, notice that the heel is going to be no lower than it is right now, because right now it's too high. That's how low it is right there when you look at it at the back. But that's deceptive, because the heel doesn't stop there. It continues all the way to midfoot. Just to be on the safe side, though, let's do our measurement again. And the way I determined this measurement, and of course it's only a guess because this is a picture of a hoof and not a hoof, I decided to measure down 1 1/4 inches. And I also noticed that there was a bit of periopal skin right about at that 1 1/4 inch mark. So that looks like I'm pretty accurate. And again, I drew my horizontal line parallel to the ground. If you notice again that the heel is not going to be any shorter for having taken off this section of hoof. This line touches the lowest part of the heel at the 1 1/8 inch part just below that periopal skin. And it also touches the place where this hoof has attempted to right itself. This is the end of this video. Notice that we haven't made any cuts yet. We've only looked at the hoof. We've only done some measuring. When we get to the underside of the hoof, that's when we're actually going to map the hoof. It will tell us what we need to do in order to draw these heels back and to shorten the toe so that the structures inside the foot are realigned in the proper order.